Previously, on Days Gone.
Please, mister.
I don't shoot women if I have a choice. Do I have a choice?
I ain't got nothing. I got nowhere to go.
Sounds like you gotta bend over and spread them. Bend over and spread them.
Jesus Christ.
And so we continue. Alright, hey guys, welcome back to Dark Saber 2220, Days Gone. What did we do again? We're clearing out this... That's right. Whatever. What are these question marks that pop up? But then, when I get close enough, it like disappears. I just keep going in that direction. Is that what it wants me to do? And what happens if I lose my car in the lake again? It told me, but... Here lies... Who cares? Who cares?
I got a use for you. I gotta clear them out. I gotta make it safer to ride through here.
That's a lot of motherfuckers, dude. Yeah. Fuck, I don't have any ammo. Gonna clear it out like this.
There's it. Let's burn it up.
God damn it, dude.
Yeah.
Ian!
Fucking perfect to throw and shit.
No, God, be the rain!
Alright, I'll come back when I have some stuff. Unless, like, let me think of something here. So it's these kind of trees in here.
Need this. Okay. Finally.
Apparently I missed it. God damn, it's about to hit me with the landing. Ha 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 ha! That's interesting. Isn't this where we were before? No wonder her face was all fucked up. It was a tire iron.
Let's see. That should do it.
How do I save it again?
Okay.
Whatever.
Leon. All right, what have we got? Maybe in one of these. That's interesting.
I didn't know I'm a tourist, dude.
Something out of this. Got it. I just gotta figure out who I'm gonna give this to.
Boozer! Booze man, are you listening? Oh, you're not gonna believe this. I just saw a goddamn chopper!
A chopper? What are you talking about?
A Nero chopper! It just buzzed right over me. It acted like I wasn't even there.
Wait, all this time and a Fed chopper shows up out of nowhere?
Yeah, I'm gonna chase them down and I'm gonna see what the hell they're doing.
Hey, Deke. Be careful. Don't get too close till you know what the hell they're doing. And don't do anything stupid.
Hell no, I'm not gonna do anything stupid.
Shit, almost out. What did you drop?
Me, dude.
Get me now! Hold on, they're slowing down. Looks like they're stopping.
researcher. What the hell are they doing out here? Gotta go check them out, see what they're doing. All right, gotta go in quiet. If they see me, I'm dead.
Okay. Right there!
Leave it. Okay, that ought to distract them.
Field note 2000.
What?
After tracking a large moving group, estimated size of 500 to 600, we have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at...
Hey Doc, I see Site 23 on the roster for tomorrow. Is that us?
No, it's O'Brien.
Got it.
Shit, where was I? We have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at the High Desert Grotto, now designated Site 15. Trampling of grasses and plants at the entrance and the presence of footprints, see attached photos, indicate the site has been used for some time. According to the motion sensor planted by Lieutenant O'Brien, approximately 447 subjects have entered the cave this morning. Recommend sending a follow-up team sometime after 1900 hours to assess the cave's interior and further assess conditions.
Did you hear that?
Dr. Anderson, your theory about the subjects devolving to a primitive state of nocturnal behavior is seeming more appealing all the time.
Distract them.
Field note 2000. After tracking a large moving group, estimated size of 500 to 600, we have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at...
Hey Doc, I see Site 23 on the roster for tomorrow. That
shit, where was I? We have confirmed the subject's hibernation location at the High Desert Grotto, now designated Site 15. Trampling of grasses and plants at the entrance and the presence of footprints, see attached photos, indicate the site has been used for some time.
Be nice and cozy in there.
According to the motion sensor planted by Lieutenant O'Brien, approximately 447 subjects have entered the cave this morning. Recommend sending a follow-up team sometime after 1900 hours to assess the cave's interior and further assess conditions. Note to Dr. Anderson, your theory about the subjects devolving to a primitive state of nocturnal behavior is seeming more appealing all the time. End report.
Not going inside.
Fucking O'Brien.
Didn't you hear me? Over 400 subjects, and these aren't just your regular run-of-the-mill freaks. These are stage 3.
They're sleeping like babies.
No.
And I asked if you were going in.
Can't be.
I didn't didn't say I was.
And these subjects are not sleeping. They're hibernating. Ever woken up a hibernating bear?
No.
Ever woken up a hibernating freak?
Yeah, actually. I was one of the survivors at the White King Mine.
Jesus.
Someone tear my buddy apart like it was peeling a banana. These suits protect you from a lot of shit. But not them.
Holy shit, Corporal. Jesus, I'm sorry.
That mission was fubar from the start.
Which is why we are not going inside there.
I think if I sealed up this cave, we'd, I don't know, knock down their population.
I don't know, Corporal. A lot of caves out here. Come on, let's get out of here.
Seal the caves. Yeah, right, like anyone gives a damn.
I heard something.
Boozer, you there? Boozman, come back.
Deke, hey, I'm here.
When we rode on a farewell, the Nero guy, the soldier,
whatever the hell he was,
who took Sarah.
What are you?
He had an ID badge. What was the name?
Oh, God, O'Brien. Couldn't shut up about it. All the way out to Three Finger Jack.
Okay, he's alive, Boozer. He's alive.
What are you talking about? We were there. The whole camp was wiped out.
No, I know that, but I heard... Okay, look. I went into their LZ, and they...
Wait. You went into their LZ? What the...
Just listen to me. I heard them over the radio. They were talking about a man named O'Brien.
Deke, don't.
I'm not, Boozer. I'm not. I'm just... Hey, get some sleep. Deacon out.
What's going on here? Still got this. Scrap. Fuel can. This is it. All right, where? You're mine now.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. This earth...
Oh, not a snare, no, I walked right into that shit, damn it!
Oh shit, I gotta get out of here. Get my gear and not let him see me.
Got it.
What was it?
Men coming!
You there? Booze man, come back.
Deke, hey, I'm here.
We rode on a farewell.
Alright, so let me try this shit again.
Okay. I can use these. Okay, at last. Which way? Back on track.
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. The start of this living hell that is now our life came as a surprise to no one who was listening to me when shit went down. And I was with a few.
Kill the son of a bitch!
Most who spoke out against the feds, well, things didn't go so great for them. The cemeteries are filled with martyrs. Those who sought to call
out the
shit and the lies when they saw it.
He killed them!
Because they came after me. I started Radio Free Oregon in the last weeks before the feds fell.
What the hell's he doing? He's running around like that!
An unmarked van, moving from town to town. In the days before the roads came drunk with cars and the bridges destroyed, trying in vain to stop the freaks. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Kill him!
Damn it. I couldn't just like
fucking...
I got
a use for you. Always
getting close to you, wanting to use elusive man funds, dude.
Boozer, you there? Booze man, come back.
Deke, hey. I'm here.
When we rode on a farewell, the Nero guy, the soldier, or whatever the hell he was, who took Sarah.
Wait, what are you...
He had an ID badge. What was the name?
Oh, God, O'Brien. He wouldn't shut up about it. All the way out to Three Finger Jack.
Okay, he's alive, Boozer. He's alive.
What are you talking about? We were there. The whole camp was wiped out.
No, I know that, but I heard... Okay, look, I went into their LZ, and they...
Wait, you went into their LZ? What the...
Just listen to me. I heard them over the radio. They were talking about a man named O'Brien.
Just listen to me. I heard them over the radio. They were talking about a man named O'Brien.
Deke, don't.
I'm not, Boozer. I'm not. I'm just... Hey, get some sleep. Deacon out.
See if I can just fucking...
This is Radio Free Oregon. The truth shall set you free. The start of this living hell that is now our life came as a surprise to no one who was listening to me when shit went down. And I was one of the few. Most who spoke out against the feds, well, things didn't go so great for them. The cemeteries are filled with martyrs. Those who sought to call out the bullshit and the lies when they saw it.
What happened to that thing?
Because they came after me. I started Radio Free Oregon in the last weeks before the feds fell. Broadcast from an unmarked van, moving from town to town. In the days before the Rose King choked with cars and the bridges destroyed, trying in vain to stop the freaks. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon.
Trap.
Don't believe the lies.
No, Cope, the cemeteries are filled with freakers, not martyrs. And you had to keep moving, because if anyone had found your unmarked van, they would have blown it to hell. Just so I wouldn't have to listen to your bullshit Radio Free Oregon.
Optional shit, man. Dude, fuck. Stay hungry.
Damn it, sniper ambush.
Ambush, are you, huh? I can use this. Mine now.
Try it at least. All right, let me try it at least.
A lot of ammo left.
Damn.
I can fix this. Good.
Oh, fuck me.
Another bounty. Okay.
Have been spotted in the skies. You might have seen them. Heard them. Thought you were losing your mind. But you're not. They're real. And they're proof that I was right. We thought Nero died out here like the rest of them, caving under their own stupidity. But no. Like I said, they've been lying and wait all this time. Out of their holes and reclaim this world. But it ain't happening. Not on my watch.
Wonder what
the Doku running towards him, thinking they're gonna save your ass. Any man wearing a uniform worth a damn died more than 2 years ago. These men, they'll shoot you on sight. This is Mark Copeland for Radio Free Oregon. Don't believe the lies.
Jenny's out of gas. Jenny's always out of gas. Can of fuel. Scrap. Oh, here we go.
Now I know better, though.
This way. gotta take a closer look.
I see. Finding.
Gotcha.
It feels, yes. It's gonna bring them all down on me. All right, here we go. Not all of them. Yeah, Jesus.
God damn it, I wanted to close the walls in there.
Another micro recorder.
What?
One of these is going to explain what the hell you guys are doing out here.
Ma'am, you must return to your vehicle. We will get to you. For 12 hours, I've got 2 sick children in the back. We need... We don't have any water. We just need a little bit of water.
Ma'am, you must return to your vehicle now.
Yes,
Nero, Jack. You've got some bottled water.
Oh, yeah.
Give
that's
it to
why
her.
These Nero things
give
are good.
It to her.
Thank you. Okay.
Oops. Alright, so yeah, I'll do the
better living through chemistry.
I'm so sorry.
Dude, I'll do all the neuro checkpoints if they're worth it, I guess.
What's going on? What's wrong?
I lied to her.
What?
They're not letting anyone else through.
Can I store, like, a weapon?
Who's this?
I hope we can say I'm a friend.
Listen, you creep. It's not your money we want. It's your ass.
I'm sorry to hear that.
What the fuck is this piece of shit?
Like, comment, and subscribe, or I'll break your fucking legs.